आई थिंक बहुत ज़्यादा एक्साइटमेंट है और थोड़ी बहुत नर्वसनेस भी है बिकॉज इट्स माई फर्स्ट शो दैट आई एम होस्टिंग एंड ऑडिशंस की जहाँ तक बात है अच्छे चल रहे हैं, काफ़ी अच्छा रिस्पॉन्स आ रहा है. The youth is interested in a show like this and you know the youth wants to date one another and explore these kind of things, so I'm sure everyone's very excited about it. So you know the concept is very relatable. It's nothing out of the box new, but it's a sweeter version of these, you know, romantic shows that come up where, you know, the guy and the girl is competing for each other. But here things are going to be very sweet, very cute, and like the tasks are going to be very nice. It's not going to be like physical strength always, sometimes maybe, but mostly it's going to be like nice stuff which audience watches and goes like, oh, so cute. I think I want to thank Bigg Boss for getting me here, because I always was interested in this industry, but I never really took that step that I'll quit my job and I'll come to Bombay, because I was leading a very secure life in Delhi. So for me, it was a big, big decision, but I'm glad that I, you know, because now when people look at me and they say that, hey, you know, it was good that you took a risk and, you know, you quit your job and now you wouldn't have been here had I not had the courage to take that risk and to give up my job. I could have been eliminated in 1 week, right? Yeah. So that would have been really bad, but thank God that I stayed for 3 months. I just feel like I could have contacted so many designers for like outfits to wear on the show, but I was too nervous thinking. I was just like, am I going to get in? Am I not going to get in? What's going to happen? So I just ended up packing my own clothes and just going to Bombay. So I could have done that maybe. I mean, I honestly am, anyone who asks me, what do you want to do? I say, I want to do good work. So good work could be movies, could be TV, could be web series, could be anchoring events, anything. I mean, I'm just up for doing good work and being productive and utilizing my talents, which are quite a few. I think it should be a demand of the character. If the character doesn't need to be bold and, you know, then you don't need to be any bold scenes, then it just looks very cheap and tacky, honestly. But I want to, if I feel like, oh my God, I want to play this character, I want to play this girl, and that requires the scenes or the script requires it because it's a part of the story, then I think I should be okay. Actually, I had a very cute, pretty girl next door image, and that is how I am. But I am also very comfortable in my skin. I mean, I probably didn't have the ideal perfect figure in Bigg Boss, but I still wore a bikini because when I go swimming, I wear a bikini. I don't wear, you know, like a skirt and a top, of course. I mean, nobody does that, but whenever I'm going out, even if I'm fat, thin, whatever, I will wear, that is a swimming costume, right? So, I mean, I'm very comfortable with my skin. And if you look at my Instagram, last to last year also, you will see similar pictures. But now after Bigg Boss, people have started noticing them, you know? So that's why people think that maybe she's trying to be hot and sexy, but that's just me. No, that is so common because firstly, there was a really good response. Like, I just randomly went for swimming to like Marriott in Bombay, and randomly just with friends, and just uploaded a picture, and it wasn't even a bikini, it was a normal leotard swimming costume, a black one, and that picture went viral. Like, every newspaper, every online portal posted that picture saying Nitibha Kaul looking hot in her, da da da. So it just felt like, oh my God, I'm just uploading a random picture and everyone's like talking about it. That's so cool. Like, I'm so cool. But I mean, honestly, I think a lot of people need to get their head sorted with, you know, slut shaming. I don't think that happened with my pictures. But yeah, body shaming somewhere down the line, people do that. And I usually don't respond to haters. But when there is something which I feel like I am responsible towards, like a topic that is very sensitive and I should not ignore, like, you know, body shaming, I do comment. So in that black picture, there were some weird comments. And I did comment back about body shaming because I don't take any nonsense on my Instagram. Yeah, see, I think honestly every rumor between Manveer and I happened because the chemistry was really good. So, we are really good friends. I think he's one of my good friends in Bombay. So, we do chill a lot together. But we're friends, you know, that's it. So, people still are speculating and still saying stuff. So, let them. Kya farak padta hai? I think both of them are really poles apart. I don't know how they got along in the show, but they're poles apart, you know, in terms of how their personalities are. Like Manveer is more like a boy next door, Dilka sorted and all of that. Manu is more like the, you know, like the sharp, witty guy. So, I mean, they have very unique personalities, both of them. But that desiness is there. Both of them have that in common. So, I don't think, I mean, I find both of them intelligent. They wouldn't have reached where they reached in Bigg Boss had they not been smart. So, yeah. It's really nice. I mean, see, he does have a flair, like, you know, that, you know, he's very sharp about things and very smart with things. But, I mean, that's who he is. And even in Bigg Boss, he used to say things about me and stuff. I knew that, and I knew that is a part of his personality. And I was okay with it because, as you know, I didn't care about any, I mean, I was sorted in my head about everything. So, I was fine. And as a person to be with on a show like this, he's a very sweet guy. He is very chivalrous also. So he's a very nice person to be around. No, he hadn't discussed that on the show because he didn't feel it was important to discuss it. Because, you know, I don't want to comment on the relationship. But there wasn't anything. I mean, they're as good as separated. So, I mean, didn't really get bothered by it because, you know, some things of your personal life you don't want to share on national TV, which is fine. Of course, I was surprised, but I mean, that was what it was. They were worried. They were really worried. They were like, what are you doing? Are you really quitting your Google job for a show? Of course, they knew it was a big show, but they also were unsure of how long I'm going to last. And they also were, you know, initially, when someone says, I'm going to take part in Bigg Boss, parents also don't process it. But when you see your daughter on screen with Salman Khan and like the whole thing is happening, that's when they got excited about it and, you know, they forgot the worries.